Okay.
And Tanya, who you haven't met yet, is up. And they're gonna talk about branding and other business opportunities and also insurance, how that may fit, and e-learning.
Who would you like to start?
Well, you might describe who you are and then you guys can take it from there.
Okay, that's great. All right, my name is Tanya Eberhardt. I am a speaker, an author, and an agent to Business Stars. Own the company called Brandface. And I do a lot of training, both in-person, instructor-led training, and then through an online training platform. I work with clients across all kinds of industries. Most often I work with business owners, entrepreneurs, and sales professionals and people in the entertainment industry who are the face of their brand. And so the implications that this software has in the training world is incredible. And I'll let Salazar tune in at this moment, and then I'll come back and fill you in on my thoughts.
Yes, hi, I'm Theta Salazar. I go by my last name, obviously, it's a habit. 8 years in the military. I was an intelligence specialist for our great United States Navy. I served in two units, EUCOMJAC, which is European Communications Joint Analysis Command, and NAVCENT, which is basically the Navy's version of the CIA. We did counterintelligence against terrorist drug rings globally. After that, I thought it would be excellent to get my law degree. So I actually attended four different law schools. One of the reasons why I attended four different law schools is because I started my law career while I was still in the Navy. So I ended up being transferred to quite a few different law schools because my duty station shifted. And I graduated from Abraham Lincoln School of Law in beautiful downtown Los Angeles. I am also a subject matter expert in criminal and traffic for the state of California. And I served on the National Legislative Committee of the Screen Actors Guild. I was AFL-CIO delegate for SAG-AFTRA. And I'm presently on the National Television Nominating Committee for SAG-AFTRA. So I come to you with the entertainment side and as an entertainment attorney and also a government background informationalist. So
I really would have hated to follow that. And yes. Thank you for your service, Salazar.
My pleasure.
But I'll speak just for a moment on the e-learning industry. How I teach people is a mixture of live instruction and online instruction, and obviously the implications of that are tremendous. The ability to, for instance, my online training modules have video training in them, they have audio training, and they have downloadable documents, which is all text training. And so the ability to, within one module, within one training piece, to be able to translate those in 33 languages in 30 seconds is incredible. So that takes my ability to increase my revenue stream, my profit, et cetera, to the sky. And so in terms of, you know, instructor-led training and live training, imagine, if you will, someone standing on a stage and doing live training and having multiple monitors on the screen to represent every language that is represented in the room. And in real time, communicating your message to all of that audience in a way that all of them can understand very clearly what you're talking about. Again, that's just tremendous training. And then I also come from a broadcast background. I spent about 18 years in the radio industry. And I'm working with a client right now who we're trying to help syndicate a radio show. And before, you know, we started talking about the software, I was looking at that opportunity as a U.S. opportunity. And obviously wasn't even thinking beyond the English language. But now, you know, this is very exciting because we have the ability to now take this beyond the English language and present it to the world in real-time translation. And so the ability for that client to increase his revenue off of that opportunity is tremendous as well.
One of the things that I think about is, like, you know, we think about your people who are actually fortunate enough to be global changers in the original days, such as your Henry Fords, your Rockefellers, your J. Paul Gettys. Think about the impact that they made from a global perspective. Now, imagine had they had this technology. Basically, you can be the next J. Paul Getty. You can be the next Rockefeller, because you have the ability to make a global imprint based upon the technology that we are featuring here today. So it doesn't matter what your actual business module is. It doesn't matter what actual sector of society that you are in from a business perspective. This has the ability to impact every actual entity, and it can be a positive format for from the actual specifications that I mentioned to you earlier, whether it's government, whether it's media, whether it's your actual trade and commerce with your facilitation of relationships from your actual international trade and commerce agreements or your treaties. So that's what brings me to the forefront, because I've said it before, I enjoy the possibility of making money. I love the revenue. But I even am much more enthralled with the opportunity to change the world for the better. And that's what I actually see this technology is. So the actual possibilities are limitless. It's only going to be your imagination that stops you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm in stereo. Look at me. So, Melissa has some other features and benefits of this that we haven't demonstrated yet. By the way, thank you for coming, Manpreet. This is Manpreet. He came all the way from India today. So, if you would take 10 minutes and go through other features.
Yes, absolutely. So the first thing that I'd like to do is outline what they are, and then I'd like to show them, just to give everybody kind of a good idea. So a first thing is that you are able to instantaneously have the ability to communicate with people in 33 different languages, but aside from that, you're able to create e-learning content in 33 different languages. So for example, Tanya would have the ability to go in and to create a simulation on literally any process that she wanted to, and essentially create a simulation or create an e-learning course so that she would then be able to take that content and embed it on a website. So if, for example, if I have a writing website, for example, if I'm teaching people how to write, I have the ability to actually create the content in 33 different languages, provide the video then in the other language, and then at the very end, even embed an assessment if I'd like to ensure that people can actually be tested on this. So if I have, for example, a web portal that I'm trying to develop for students, I can give them each usernames and passwords so that they can then go to the website, they can consume the e-learning content, and then at the end, I can actually have a full report that lets me know how every single person did. So it's a very powerful software that is not only just for language translation, but it's also for learning and for creating content. So that means that I can create not only the voice translation, but I can also create different content. So basically, would you like to speak a little bit more, Tanya, to what that would mean for e-learning?
Sure. Absolutely. So as I was saying, I have the, in my own company, we have, I teach among a couple of different ways, live training, online training, and then of course one thing we haven't talked about yet is the web conferencing, which of course everybody does now because it beats the heck out of traveling so far, right?
Oh, yes, absolutely.
Exactly. So the ability to take what Melissa was talking about, the video portion, audio, text, and instantly translate that is incredible. But I can envision being on a web conference now and not having that language barrier, just completely removing that, and having, you know, 10, 15 people from different countries, different continents, if you will, being able to easily communicate back and forth in real time, that changes the scope of e-learning completely.
Absolutely.
And so it's so exciting to me. My head spins a lot. You know, since I've learned about this software, I stay up late at night trying to figure out how can we utilize this. You know, and as Salazar so effectively put it, it's not just about making money. It's really about changing the world and changing the way that we communicate with each other. And e-learning is, since e-learning has become so prominent with, you know, the rise in tuition in a lot of your, you know, your schools, a lot of the schools have gone to online learning. And so I think that is the wave of the future, and this can completely change that wave.
Absolutely. Let's face it, instructor-led training is terrible. I mean, it's boring, you fall asleep. You know, I mean, typically you forget around 80% of everything that you learn within 2 weeks. So for that reason, being able to have content that's available for you on demand on a mobile device, on an iPhone, on an iPad, real time when you want to hear it. So I can be in the grocery store, not picking out the right groceries, if you will, because I'm consuming my e-learning content. So there's a lot of power in being able to have that mobility and being able to ensure that you're able to have that level of, you know, basically learning on demand.
Right. And just another neat side note to that is that when you're doing all the e-learning and there's the video component where people can see you, it would be really tough to fall asleep and get away with it.
Yeah, no, you're absolutely right. That's very true.
That's right. That's true.
Yeah, people would actually see you snoring.
That's true.
When I first started training,
in different languages.
Oh, absolutely. When I first started training many moons ago, they actually sometimes would have people like get up and do like jumping jacks in the middle of training classes just to keep everyone focused and alert. So now you don't have to worry about doing jumping jacks anymore in the middle of training class.
Right. It's kind of like, you know, in church or in any kind of, you know, an event, and you're watching the the sign language person at the front, and you're thinking, wow, that's almost real time. It's interesting to see that communication going on. This is similar to that, but it does keep you in tune more because it's in your language, and so you don't,
Absolutely.
It's real time. It's fantastic.
And so you can actually, with this application, create content for literally any Windows-based application, and you can teach someone how to do anything. I could create an e-learning course on how to teach someone how to send an email, how to do, God forbid, Excel formulas. You know, so you literally have the ability to do any kind of training that you need to do. So, I mean, really, the applications are endless when you think about the fact that you could teach people. In fact, Salazar, did you want to talk a little bit more about the medical industry and kind of the way that things are changing with regulation and things like that?
Sure.
Because I think that this plays a big component there.
Yes, I am not a doctor. I have played one on television. Basically, with the medical society, which is changing, imagine if you would. Now we have